Hello everyone, I am Professor Anish Vora and I welcome you all in this video lecture. Currently, we are running a series of video lecture on home appliances. Today, in this series, we will study about water heater. The application of water heater, we know that we use heater to heat the water. If we see the classification of water heater, then we have two different types of heater. One is immersion type of heater and another is storage water heater. First, let us start with the immersion type of water heater. Let us study the principle of immersion heater. When current I flows through a resistance R for time period T, heat equal to I square RT joules is produced and the water is heated by this heat. This is the very basic principle of resistive heating we use for immersion type of heater. If we see the construction, then we have a tube that is made of either copper or stainless steel, and the lower portion of the tube is made like a coil. Nichrome wire is kept in the center of the tube and the surrounding space is filled with the mineral powder. The nichrome wire is having a very high resistivity, and we pass the current from this nichrome wire, and as per the principle I square RT, the heat is generated. We use one ebonite base at the top from which the supply cord is joined. If we see the figure, we can see that we have ebonite base to which we have connected one power cord. We have taken a tube, either it is made of copper or stainless steel, and in the tube we have inserted nichrome wire. We have some probable faults and the cause of the fault. The very common fault, that is, water does not get heated, and the probable cause, there might not be a supply. So first we have to check that whether supply is available or not. Fuse might have blown, wire in power cord might be open, heating element, that is our nichrome wire, might have get open. These are some of the causes if water is not getting heated. The second fault, that is the fuse blows off. When we start a heater, fuse blows, or sometime we experience a shock. There must be short circuit somewhere in the wire, or heating element might be touching the tube and creating the earth type of fault. Let us check the specification for immersion type of heater. 230 volt normally, that is supply voltage, and we have 1000 watt or 1500 watt capacity type of immersion heaters are available. Safety precaution: while using immersion type of heater, we must ensure that immersion heater should not be switched on until it is immersed in the water up to the mark given on it. Now next is a storage type of water heater. The application of the storage type of water heater is also similar to the immersion type of water heater, we use the heater to heat the water. Now let us see the principle. When current I flows through a resistance R for period T, heat equals to I square RT joule is produced and the water is heated by this heat. The principle, that is resistive heating, is similar in storage type of water heater as well as immersion type of water heater. Now let us study the construction of the storage water heater. We use one circular tank made of copper mostly, and the tank is tin plated to avoid the corrosion. We use another cover made of sheet steel which surrounds the tank. So we have almost construction like two tanks, and the space between the two tank is filled with glass wool that is used as insulation to the atmosphere, and radiation from the tank can be avoided. Vertical heating element is kept at the center and leads are taken outside from the bottom to connect electric supply. A vertical strip type thermostat is kept in between the heating element, which is used to control the temperature of the water. A fusible plug is kept at the top side. Sometime without water, if we start storage type of water heater, then pressure increase, and at certain level the fusible plug which is provided at the top side might melt, and the pressure generated inside the tank is released. Now in this figure we can see the construction of the storage type of water heater. We have outer cover, that is as we discussed, that is made of sheet steel, and at the inner side we have copper inner tank. This is copper inner tank and this is outer tank. In between we have insulation, and that is a glass wool. We have inlet pipe. This is inlet pipe, it takes the water in, and we have outlet water pipe to take the hot water at the outside. This is our heating element, vertical type of heating element, and leads are taken out for the electrical connection. And we use a thermostat, vertical strip type of thermostat, to maintain the temperature of the water. Thermostat is connected in series with the heating element, and as per the set temperature, it automatically shut down the supply to the heating element once the temperature exceeds the set temperature. We have one fusible plug at the top side. In case of pressure increased beyond a level, then it melts and the pressure is released. Now if we check the capacity, then the rating of the heater depends on the capacity, that is 1 kilowatt for 25 liter, 2 kilowatt for 50 liter tank, 3 kilowatt for 100 liter, and so on. Now let us discuss certain probable faults and causes of fault. The very general fault, that is water does not get heated, and the possible cause of the fault, there might not be a supply. Fuse might have blown, Wire in the power cord might have opened somewhere. Heating element might have opened. These are some of the causes if water does not get heated. Quantity of water may be insufficient. Low rating of thermostat. Capacity of the tank is less than our requirement. Next fault, that is excessive heating and steam leakage from somewhere. Thermostat setting might be high. That is one of the reason if temperature increase beyond certain level. Inoperative thermostat or earth heating element. Next fault, that is the leakage of water. It might be possible near the thermostat, near the flange of heating element, or in the pipe or different connection. We have to identify the exact location of the leakage and we have to rectify. When we start the storage heater, sometime fuse blows. There must be short circuit in the wire somewhere, or heating element might be earth and we have an earth fault. So this is all about two different types of water heater. Thank you very much for watching my video. Keep watching. Thank you very much.